I love you,
Allah. The smallest good deed, the smallest change that I have in myself can bring about the most amazing and profound effects. One of the simplest examples is the story of Musa and Fir'aun. Musa was being raised in the palace of the Pharaoh, and eventually when he punched the Egyptian and the viziers turned against him, Pharaoh turned against him, Musa flees for his life. He runs away from Egypt and he has no food, no money, just the clothes on his back, and he flees to the valley of Midian, the valley of Midian in the Quran. And he himself is a refugee. He himself doesn't even know where he's going to go. And imagine the fear, the panic, the uncertainty that Musa has. When he gets to the valley, as the Quran tells us, he sees a well that was surrounded by shepherds jostling, shoving with one another, trying to feed their flock. And as the Quran tells us, there were two ladies with their flock away from the crowd. So he goes to them and he says, مَا خَطْبُكُمَا? What is the matter with you? قَالَتَا, they said, we cannot feed our sheep until the rest of these men leave. And by that time, there's hardly going to be any water left. And don't blame us. We don't have any money to hire a servant and our father is very elderly. Musa, as we know, volunteered to help them out. Here is where one of those micro butterfly effects is taking place. Musa himself is a refugee. Musa himself has no money to give them. He can't donate anything for them, but he donates the one thing that he does have, and that is the sweat of his brow. He's physically strong. So he volunteers to take the flock, and he gives the sheep water, he hands the sheep back to the ladies, and then, like the Quran says, he walks away from them. No need to chit-chat, no need to do anything more. Keep it dignified and decent. He walks away from them, and he sits under a tree. And he makes that beautiful Quranic dua that I hope all of you memorize and make regularly. قَالَ رَبِّي إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ He said, Oh my Lord, I am a beggar to any good that you can give me. I'm a faqir, I'm a beggar. Any good you can give me, I would love it. What happens? Musa, alayhi salam, did one act of charity. This is the butterfly effect. He fed goats and sheep. That's the good deed he did. Or you can say he helped out two ladies that needed to be helped. But how was the help? To feed goats and sheep. What was the impact of that good deed? What happened? Subhanallah. Within a few hours, one of them comes back. She's embarrassed. She's shy. And she says, my father's inviting you. He wants to thank you for what you have done. So they go to the house of the father, and overnight, subhanallah, overnight, Musa has a career, he gets a salary, he gets a place to live, he gets a house, and on top of that, he gets a wife as well, mashallah, tabarakallah. Single brothers, if you want to get married, start feeding water to the people outside. When he was generous, Allah was generous to him. When he did a good deed, the butterfly effect comes into effect here. And he has no idea the consequences of his actions. What's going to happen? But subhanAllah, everything opens up. And there are many ayat and a hadith that mention the magnificent impact that a small good deed can have. For example, the hadith in Sahih Bukhari mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if one of you gives a small date in charity from his pure wealth, a date that he wants, he loves, he's earned it, and he gives it in charity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept that date, and he shall plant it, and nurture it, and water it, and it will grow and grow and grow, so much so that when on judgment day you come back, and you see this beautiful tree in your good deeds, you might say, oh Allah, I don't recognize this good deed. I didn't do this. Where is this coming from? And Allah will say, remember that one date you gave? Remember that one date you gave, but your heart was pure, you had sincerity, you gave it for the sake of Allah, I accepted that date and I nurtured it. I allowed it to grow until the results of it is what you are seeing here. Our scholars say that perhaps what could happen is that you feed somebody and you don't realize what happens after that. You change his life around. You give somebody $10. In reality, you change his entire life. He goes on and he does something else. And all of the reward are going to go to you. And so on and so forth. One good deed, it's a domino effect, might bring about thousands of other good deeds. Such that when you stand on judgment day, you will have good deeds. You don't even know where they're coming from because you used every opportunity you could to spread the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of the successful. Wa jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.